So let's go live to the US of A. there we should have Topher Brophy and his dog Rosenberg. Sorry, which is the dog and which is Topher? Topher, where are you? Oh, which one? I give up. Which one? Who's who? Who is who?
Please reveal yourself, Topher. Which one is which? I think it's his joke. Either that, we can't hear us.
What?
Oh no, he's got.
Oh hi. No, hi. I'm sorry. I'm here live with you. I just basically, we're dressed right now at the Queen's Guard. Since the UK, you're our, you know, cultural ancestors and forefathers. We wanted to show some respect and camaraderie and dress like the Queen's Guard. So that's what we were doing. We were emulating
done.
How they
Thank
behave,
you.
Like very stoic.
We salute you.
You
we
look
salute
great.
You both. Is the dog real or is it a puppet?
He is very much real, and basically he's my son, he's my companion, he's my best friend, he's my other half.
Are you sure he's real? I'm looking so closely. Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
he's
yeah. It's a little early for him, so if he basically seems a little tired, I have to excuse him for that reason. We don't usually get up this early.
Yes,
Topher, tell me how you both met and how you came into each other's lives.
Well, it's an interesting story. You know, I would say it was about 2 years ago, and at the time, I was going through a tough time personally. And basically, I wasn't in touch with my emotions and with other people enough. And to distract myself as a kind of an escape, I was addicted to competitive sports. I was spending too much of my time training many different types, dressage, weightlifting, polo, rugby. It got to the point where I was spending all my time that way. Sorry, he's a little sleepy. And I ended up actually hurting myself badly. I had a very bad herniated disc as a result of doing way too much and is trying for the escape. And at that point, I had a lot of time to myself because I couldn't play sports anymore. And then I realized, you know, I felt quite empty and I wasn't in touch with myself and I had a big void. And I knew at that point I was a self-absorbed person. And I needed to change that about myself, and caring for somebody else would help that. So that's when I started the adoption process. And that's when I adopted Rosenberg.
Get off that
basically. We're looking at pictures
we're looking
of him.
At licking.
As
we were
as
looking
a...
at licking there. What's going on?
But we're looking at pictures of him
the,
as a puppy.
The best decision I've ever made in my life. I am so much more connected to myself and then connected to other people.
Well,
he's a bridge.
Topher,
for me,
give us an insight into Rosenberg's personality, because you've been looking at the mouth moving and the hand and everything. What sort of personality has Rosenberg got?
You know, it's interesting. He and I are very much alike, more so personality-wise than we are the way we look, which is really crazy for people. Basically, he's very introspective and he's very pensive. At the same time, he can be very outgoing, and he's a bit of a prankster. He's a bit of a jokester
well,
like
we can
me.
See
we
that, share that. Topher. We're looking at the pictures of you now, dressing alike. So how did this come about? And you started posting this on Instagram, and you've got a massive following, the two of you now. Why do you do this?
Well, we first did it kind of as a joke, you know, because people said we look alike when we walked around in the street, and I didn't realize it at first. And then, as a kind of a gag, one day, we dressed up together, and at that point, people started crowding around us and making a very, very big deal, and it brought a lot of smiles to people's faces, particularly kids. And Rosenberg loves kids. He loves toddlers. He licks them, and it's the first time often that they've ever interacted with the dog, so it's a first impression.
He's looking very... He's either sleepy, but he looks like a very laid-back kind of dog, is he? I mean, does he like all this dressing up?
Yeah, he really does. He loves to be the center of attention, and he's like any, not like any other dog I've ever seen. He almost has a sense of wisdom and kind of calm. You know, in some way, I actually think that he's a relative that I lost when I was quite young, and maybe he's reincarnated because his essence and personality isn't like a dog that I've ever met before. But when we saw it was bringing people so much joy to dress alike, then we realized that it was a way we can give back and make people happy and spread love.
Do you go out like that? I know you post the pictures, but do you actually go out dressed like
we
dressed
do,
this morning?
We do, and I just want to say that we started to realize that, and then we sought out and we found the most amazing photographer who photographs, styles, dogs all around the world, and she's our partner, she's our creative director, she's the real brains and talent. Her name is Chantal Adair. although her moniker is the dog styler, it's also her Instagram handle. She's the real brains behind here, and she's with our collaboration. That's how I bring everything to life.
If you enjoyed that, there's more of the same right here. And make sure you subscribe so that you never miss the best moments from This Morning.